I've read your comments, I hear your concerns and your questions loud and clear. We're gonna try to answer some of those troubleshooting issues today, and if I can't help you, I'm gonna point you in the direction to the dev team on Cudominer that can assist. Stay tuned.
Nerdy dude stuff.
That good stuff. For those of you keeping track at home, today's beverage of the day is a Samuel Adams Lawn Chair Lager. It's part of their summer variety pack that they released. It's pretty solid. I'm a huge fan of Sam Adams, being one of the bigger distributed beers. Usually I like microbreweries and stuff like that, support like the locals, but I'm a sucker for Sam Adams. So cheers to you guys. Oh yeah, oh yeah, that's crisp and refreshing as a nice hopsy lager. Anywho, currently taking a look at Algorand, we are at 5,552. We've received a total lifetime rewards of 106, which is fantastic. We do have everything over here on the Algo Optimizer. We're going to be coming out with a video shortly in regards to the annual percent yield changing versus Coinbase. So stay tuned for that here within the week. For those of you that notice a QR code above my head or a wallet address in the description of this video, that is if you like this content, to consider sending a tip with a comment so we can read it out on air, as long as well as like, comment, and subscribing, blah, blah, blah. But once again, I do want to make sure I give proper credit and dues to everyone that has sent an Algo tip in the past day or so since I've done the last video, and just make sure that you guys are thanked, because I truly, truly appreciate it. It really keeps me going. It helps me stay motivated. I, you know, really like providing this content and researching and everything. So if you guys appreciate it, all tips are appreciated as well. First off, we got a 7 Algorand tip yesterday. Not sure who you are, but it looks like it came from Coinbase because of that 0.002 fee. So thank you very much. If that was you and you're watching this video, thank you very much. I don't think there's going to be a lot of Algo people watching this video since it is about Cudominer, but if you are, thank you. Then we received another tip for 2 Algorand, and this one says, happy birthday, nerdy dude. Yes, thank you very much. Yesterday was my birthday, which is why I did not do a video as stated, but thank you very much for the birthday tip. I truly and heavily and highly appreciate it. And lastly here, we have a 1.25 Algorand tip as well. It says, happy B-Day, keep up the good work. I'm trying, super trying. We're at a situation with work where we're kind of like spread out a little bit, so we're able to get these videos out, and I really like putting them out. So thank you very much, guys. I really, really, really appreciate it. Now, we are gonna drag the Cudominer over here onto the screen. There we go. We're gonna move it over. Boom. And then we're going to go ahead and jump onto the web page back here and give that a good old refresh. Computer's running a little slow at the moment. I do have an update I need to do. And this is an older gaming computer, so it kind of takes a little bit of a beating. But anywho, we are popping off on the Algo payout on Cudominer. So we're not mining Algorand. We're mining Monero and Ethereum Classic and Ethereum and getting paid out in Algorand. Now, I do know that the minimum payout is 20 Algorand. And I've seen a few comments stating that there is issues with the withdrawals, so some people are a little hesitant about that. We are going to continue to test and push forward to get to that 20 and see if we also have a withdrawal issue. That's some of the comments that I wanted to address. And if we do, we are going to raise hell. We're going to do videos about it, and we're going to see if we can make some waves to get those payouts done appropriately, because we are working. I mean, whether we're not working, our computers are working, and we deserve those payouts. So as of right now, we are up to 8 Algorand, which is very, very solid. And you can see over here on the chart, you probably won't be able to see. Let me move it to where the QR code might not be in the way. Nah. Well, let me move me. Ha ha! Let me move me. No, it's probably going to leave that in the way. Anyway, woo, look at me go. Ah! Anyway, so you could, if you could see the chart based on where I put the QR code, I might put it up here somewhere. We have been doing all the mining and the work here. We do have a very small commission from referrals, so we have a little bit there, but everything else has pretty much been our GPU and everything mining, which we'll pull back up here. Now, there's a couple things. I was trying to find out. I know someone was having issues running on their MacBook Pro, and I really haven't found much information on that. I've scoured YouTube. The videos that I did find pull it up, and they show unpacking it and just running it and making sure, you know, re-downloading and the proper permissions are put out there. So I really didn't find much there other than that you have to make sure you download the right Cudominer. It would say Mac OS, and that would get you going technically. So if you have an error or anything that's telling you, please let me know what that is. Otherwise, at later towards this video, we are going to provide the Telegram for their customer service and their dev team to help get you facilitated. Because I don't use Macs, I only use iPhones. And so I really don't know that system. And even when I was watching these videos or going through these tutorials, like I couldn't even commit it to memory on the steps they were taking. So I really don't have that full answer for you. Now, another subscriber was saying that their GPU and their CPU weren't firing up. And I think we have some quick fixes for that for you to double check. We'll go over that in just a second. And then another commenter was saying that they were having an error that said, the caller doesn't have permission to execute the specified operation. What can I do? What I've seen here, I found this on Reddit, was that someone just stated that if you're using Chrome and it's giving that issue, switch over to, I don't know, Brave browser or Microsoft Edge, Mozilla Firefox, or CryptoTab browser, and that should get you going, especially if it's showing you that on the dashboard web page. So give that a try if you're using Chrome. I know it's nice, but we have other internet or, you know, browsers and blah, 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 so that you can give them a try as well. Now, let's go back over here to the miner to try some troubleshooting. And what I think you might need to do is jump into your settings. And after we restart our computer, we're going to be doing a few of the, we're not going to be doing the troubleshooting because we are currently mining, no problem. But let's get the settings. Come on. All right. So the first thing is you want to make sure that the firewall allows it through. Right now, I have Windows Defender exclusion, so it's allowing it to get through Windows Defender. But I also went into my Windows Defender and forced it through as well. So you might want to try that. Or for the first time you get it up and running, turn off your Windows Defender, run it, and then turn it back on, and you should be good to go. You also, for your GPUs, this is one thing I had to make sure I did, was enable third-party miners. It gives you a warning screen about that, but just go into your settings and turn it back on if you turned it off before. And then I'm going to be turning on overclocking to see what the changes will get when we get going, and then automatically enable new workloads, and hopefully that fires you off. And then there's scheduling stuff, but we're not really going to worry about here. MAC address, no, don't know. So we're going to go into our algorithm. And then the other thing you need to do with your GPU, and I covered this before, so I'm not going to go through every single one like I did before, but if you're having issues and it's not running, once your third-party mining software is up, you need to go into each and every single coin, each and every one, and you need to disable them. You need to turn them off. So you go into Bitcoin Gold, Equihash on LOL Miner, turn that off, leave it off, then go into the next one, turn it off, leave it off, and you want to turn off all of these that are on your screen. And then once that's done, wait a few seconds and then start from the top and go back and turn them all back on. And that should get you going. So let's kind of, actually, I do want to take a stab at this real quick, but that should get you going. Otherwise, if you're not getting it to run successfully, I am going to link the Telegram in the description of this video, and you can jump in there and you can start talking to people there. I need to start up other computer currently mining in Windows on my Mac, and mouse is disabled for some reason. I think it's Cudo app, blah, blah, blah. So you can go here, and they look like they're pretty quick. Like right now, Matthew developer responded about 20 minutes ago, and you can see I just joined the group as well. So you go into this. Make sure that if anyone ever responds back out to you, you don't send them any crypto, because there will probably be people lurking in here looking for people that are asking questions to try to take advantage of them. So be very, very, very careful. Hopefully the Telegram group, because I'm very new to Cudominer, and so I didn't have any issues. I was able to plug and play and get it going. So that's the only reason why I think that, you know, I don't know because I'm so new to it, but as I use this more, you know, especially if that withdrawal goes through and there's no problem with it, then I'll be able to have more answers. All right, so let's take a stab real quick at the overclocking. Right now, we are currently mining at a 9.93 hash rate. I still got to get a couple of extenders so I can get my other GPU in there. Let's enable overclocking, see what happens. Yep, enable overclocking. So let's go ahead and we've got that on. Let's go back to our dashboard and kind of see what that did for us. See if anything bumps up or if I have to restart it or put it back on. See if the speeds increase. Increasing a little. Increasing a little more. See if actually benchmarks will show us. Now that we've got it actually set on overclock, So yeah, all right. So it pumps us up to, nope, never mind. Just kidding. It hasn't pumped us up yet. So maybe I have to disable it and turn it back on. Or actually, you know, let's just disable and turn it back on. See if the hash rate goes back up. Stopping. Oh, there we go. Applying configuration, error, no jobs queued, and enable. Let's see if that jumps back up. Not, well, we're starting. Still saying 16 algo. It fluctuates around. Not running it on the CPU at the moment just because of how slow it'll make this video go. Otherwise, I probably have to fart around with the overclocking on the GPU and then get it to the settings I usually like and then come back into here and turn it back on. But let's see if it changes. We'll have a sip of beer while we wait. No? Come on, you got to start, buddy. Come on, let's do it. Got it going. All right, now we're running. And we're starting at 10.71. Let's see if it goes up even more. Yeah, okay, we got to fart around with some overclocking settings on our GPU and stuff like that. And I'll try the CPU later, but I'm not going to do that on video. Anywho, that's going to do it for me, guys. Sorry I didn't really have the full 100% answers, you know, just because of my unfamiliarity with MacBooks. That's bad on me. But you do have the Telegram group that you can now reach out to. And if you have the solutions, let me know in the comments as well what worked for you. That way it better educates me so I can provide those answers in the near future. This is a very new platform for me. We've only been in it for about a week. I'm having fun so far, but I want to make sure that our concerns are addressed. And so you guys can help me and I can help you. So help me to help you, you know, let's just go from there. But that's going to be it today. Once again, QR code above my head for Algorand and a wallet address in the video. Any and all tips are greatly appreciated. And I'll make sure I give you guys shout outs on each and every video that I do film. As always, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, turn on the bell notification, all that good stuff. I'm Oprius, and we'll see you guys next time.